I'm talking Dior, I'm talking Balenciaga, I'm talking, and they were just for sale for a dollar because nobody wanted hats. And since she had kind of taught me, you can go first class and I have to pay a bunch, and I saw, oh my gosh, these are being abandoned, these hats. And everything that went with a hat is being pushed to the back bedroom. So I picked up my first Coco Chanel hat and bought it. And then 500 hats later, I think is what y'all told me, and several hundred hat boxes, I had to make a decision. Is this the way, is this fair to my family to have this all over the house? And also, I realized I had the opportunity to do some remodeling, so the museum was just very gracious, and we developed the partnership, and they accepted the hats, and I kept getting a running total of, do you know how many hats you gave us? And so it was, that's what got me into hat collecting. But being raised, having so many women that were influences in my life as well, and I have a love of history, it started to become a story for me in addition to just being hats. And so I will tell you, when you are, how many of y'all would admit publicly that you're a collector? I mean, I have to say I am. And so if you are, you go to look for maybe a hat or a piece of furniture, you know what you're supposed to be going for, but you end up with something else. And so I will show you. So every time I would find a hat, then there'd be something else. But let me start with, this describes my Aunt Rosemary the best. I inherited this from her, and it's an Art Deco pin, and it's phenomenal. And she was a classy dame, and so when I would see a hat like that, I might see a pin like that. So for a while there, I was kind of doing, do I want this, do I want that? But this is like a pin that I found this at Lakewood years ago when we had Lakewood Antiques. And then picked up this little lady that I think defines so much. And I'll talk about some other accessories over there later, but I thought it would help you to know. But one time, and this is when I had to get hold of collecting the other things, I kept unfolding this. It was at one of those, you know, places. I kept looking at it and trying to figure out what it was. And so let me see how. So I finally asked the lady, and it's a bra. And so I had to get, I mean, it's gorgeous lace, first of all. Yeah. But that is just one style of dressing for women. And I thought, okay, but you really like hats. If you don't get older, you're going to get in trouble. But I just love that. So it's fun to talk about. Let's see if I, so once you start collecting a bunch of things, you kind of back into the realization that you need to at least define what you're doing, make it, you know, valid, credible. So I started collecting books. We didn't have computers back then. And this became my resource book. I loved this book, and I don't know if it's in print anymore or not, but it was just a great, it showed you your hats, and it described who the milliners were, and about couture, and then different styles of hat. So I just wanted to show you that I had I used to teach school, so it became a matter of learning a way to learn about the things that I love to collect. So, and that has become a reference point for me for several things. And I'm going to just do a little bit of history here, but not long. So. From this book that I just showed you, and while I'm holding it, these are some designs of just classic styles of hats. And I used to do a lot of talks on hats, and thank heavens I saved this and can look at it. So I want to walk us through the end of the 19th century into the 20th century and into this century. So I'm going to start off just with summaries, and then I figured out the best way to make y'all understand what that period of history. So in the 19th century, in the early 20th century, especially in the 19th century, the end of the 19th century, the clothing became cumbersome. You had your bulk armor, you had your stiffening, you had the hats, you could knock on them and hear a sound. I mean, they were just hard made like that. But by the 20th century, the classic cloche began to dominate. And that was when women could cut their hair finally and wear something like that. But, and we'll talk a little bit about etiquette, throw it in here, hatlessness was never an option. You could not go anywhere. If you didn't have a hat on, you were breaching the very rigorous etiquette of the day. So I thought that was an interesting point. The milliners, the hatters,
Excuse me, was that in the 1900s then? The early 1920s,
all like that. When the clothes and think Downton Abbey. Place that on a time scale. So some of the milliners that were that you would save your money if you could to buy were like Agnès, Rose de Caen, Marie-Alphonse Rabou, Jean Patou, Chanel. But really this gives you time and place when you know that the movie star was Gloria Swanson. So if you can think of the old movies and place it that way. Now I'm going to move from the 20s into the 30s. And the decades didn't have stops and starts where style was concerned. Style would come in gradually, gain prominence, and then gradually either become a classic or just move on. So in the 1930s, individuality and hat styles were popular, and I love this hat. And I'm supposed to tell you a little bit about proper etiquette, so let me see if I can pull this off. So you look for your label, and then you put your hat on, and look how big my head is. So anyway, you put the hat on, and this is the veil, this is how you were. And was I not feminine? I mean, you know, I could pull it off of the fitted Chanel suit, such as that. But it was very proper to smoke cigarettes. And women would have the cigarette holder, and she would never, ever light her own cigarette. So a gentleman was to light the cigarette. And so here's the process. If Jeff came up to me and he said, "May I pull out my little cigarette holder, my cigarette, and he says, may I light it for you?" He said, "Oh." So you would lift your veil like this, and you would look into the man's eyes, and you would have the cigarette holder here as he would light your cigarette. So it was a whole party process that went along with lighting a cigarette. In a way, I'm kind of sad some of that ritual was gone. But this hat, to me, as simple as it is, defines a very classy lady. I kind of said, all right, she has to have had black hair. You know, I'm just trying to figure out. And